So, welcome to the session. In today's class, we are going to discuss about Reynolds number. So, how we are going to relate with critical velocity efficiency. So, along with that, different kinds of forces efficiency. So, cohesive force and adhesive force, and some of the example for cohesive force and adhesive force efficiency. And along with that, so here, what is the meaning of surface tension efficiency? So here, how we are going to represent and what is the SI unit and what is the dimensional formula for surface tension efficiency. So first, Reynolds number. So we know how to represent Reynolds number mathematically. So based on that, we are possible to classify the flow of liquid. So already we know. So Reynolds number. So according to Reynolds, critical velocity of liquid flowing through a narrow tube. So how they are related? So it is directly proportional to the coefficient of viscosity of the liquid, and second factor, so it is inversely proportional to the diameter of the tube. Therefore, critical velocity and the Reynolds number, how it is represented? So here, critical velocity is directly proportional to coefficient of viscosity, whereas it is inversely proportional to density and the diameter. So that is given by the formula, Vc is directly proportional to eta divided by rho into d. Or you can represent that critical velocity is equal to R, and R is the Reynolds number, d is the coefficient of viscosity, rho into d. Rho is the density, d is the diameter. Same thing, it is also represented as R is equal to, so here Vc is the critical velocity, rho is the density, and d is the diameter, and eta is the coefficient of viscosity. So here, like this, Reynolds number and critical velocity, how they are related, that is represented by the mathematical formula. You can represent like this, or you can represent like this, or you can represent like this. So you have to remember all these formula because these are helpful while solving the problems. So next concept we shall see, different kinds of forces. So cohesive force and adhesive force, and some of the example for those kind of forces. So force of cohesion. So force of cohesion. So what is the meaning of that? So force of attraction between the molecules of same kind is nothing but, that is force of cohesive force or force of cohesion we are going to call. Same thing, some of the example for cohesive force are two drops of liquid. So that is coils into one and brought in mutual contact because of cohesive force. Same thing, second example is, so it is difficult to break drop of mercury because of large cohesive force is present in case of mercury drop. So these are some of the example for cohesive force. And third one, so it is difficult to separate two sticky plates of glass wetted with water. Why? Because large force has to apply against the cohesive force. So that is one of the example for cohesive force. Next one, next type, that is force of adhesion or adhesive force. So force of attraction between the molecules of different kind or different substance. If force exists between two different kinds of substance, so that we are going to call force of adhesion. So some of the example we shall see. So adhesive force enables us to write on the black paper with the chalk because those are two different kinds of substance. So second one, due to force of adhesion, water wets glass plate due to presence of adhesive force. And third one, chemical and gum are used in gumming of two surface. So these are some of the example for adhesive force. Same thing, next we shall see the basic definition of surface tension. So surface tension, that is also one of the property of liquid. So what kind of property? So that is the property of liquid at rest by virtue of which liquid surface tends to occupy minimum surface area and behaves like a stretched membrane. And surface tension is always represented by the formula. Surface tension is represented by the letter T is equal to force divided by L, where F is nothing but total force on either side of the imaginary line. L is the length of the line. Therefore, surface tension is given by the formula T is equal to force by L. So, and SI unit used to measure the surface tension is Newton per meter, or you can use dynes per centimeter. And dimensional formula force is given by M L T minus 2, and length is measured in terms of meter, therefore it is represented as L, and the dimensional formula for surface tension is M L 0 and T minus 2. So this is the basic definition of surface tension. And SI unit used to measure the surface tension is Newton per meter, or you can use dyne per centimeter, and the dimensional formula is M L 0 and T minus 2. So you have to remember different formulas used to measure Reynolds number. And next, different kinds of forces, that is cohesive force and the adhesive force, and some of the example for those. And next we discussed about what is the meaning of surface tension and what is the formula used to represent surface tension and what is the dimensional formula for the surface tension we discussed. So all these concepts you have to remember, because based on these formula we are going to solve, based on Reynolds number we are going to solve the problems also.